What's up, lads? Midnight Kid here, bringing you fixtures 2-6 in season 5. It's well and truly underway. And what a goal from Fellaini to kick the video off. Beautiful into the top right hand corner. The Afro man just puts it in. Beautiful. Watch this. Watch this now. Bang. Our trigger wrapped his foot around it as only Fellaini can. Afro man, as I call him. That's his pet name. So my next goal and my next match against Southampton is Rivieri. Beautiful goal there. I think that was the prestige slatting it home from Belhanda's assist. Brilliant. Great interception from Belhanda. Just puts it on to him. Has time to stop. Has time to look around, wave to the crowd, and then just chips it over him. Beautiful lob. So the next one I played was fixture 5. And I did play fixture 4 as well, obviously, but I was a nil-all draw, I think. But this is the pick of the goals of the video. What a goal from Miachi. Beautiful, beautiful strike. RB powered into the top right-hand corner. There's nothing the goalkeeper can do. Goes in off the post eventually, I think. But, I mean, that's just a superb finish. And who says you can't finish in Pez? I think you just need to learn the fundamental basics of the shooting in Pez. And then you can be a beast at it. But the Champions League group match 1 saw me resume my rivalry with Bayern Munich. They beat me on penalties in the Super Cup. There's Bubba. He's a big, big lad. He is a big, big lad. He almost needs planning permission to just play on the pitch. He's so big. He needs scaffolding to support his neck. But this is the Champions League. I'm hoping to get out of the group. The first stage, of course, I want to get through the group. I mean, like, I need to make a good start to the Champions League this season and not be kind of faltering through it and stumbling through it. So it starts off, I'm playing solo today, and it starts off at a hectic pace. I'm just trying to spread the ball around. Maybe feed my strikers a little bit quicker this time in this game and do something different against the Super Cup. And straight away, I'm just kind of dominating possession. And one of the good things about Pez, unlike FIFA, which I've played a good bit of FIFA lately as well, and, you know, I think it's okay, but it's not as good as Pez, obviously. But I think that the unpredictability in the matches, you'll never play the same team. You could play the same team 100 times and 100 matches will be different. So, I mean, I think they should be praised for that it's totally different games. Sometimes they play to the strikers, sometimes they play to the wingers, sometimes they're just really good defensively. But all the teams are different. So, I'm just really coming into my own here now. Watch, I'm up the wing, make a lovely off-the-ball run with Wagner Love. He's starting today. Thiago Silva's at the back for them. What a turn, though. It doesn't matter. And it's in the back of the net from Vaggy. That's how it's done. Thiago Silva, I think, cost Bayern Munich 150 million or something crazy like that. He is the best player in the game, I think. He's the best defender. He's an absolute monster. But Vaggy, what a goal. He's back with a bang on the Champions League scene. Beautiful goal. Unbelievable. Just turned him like a sixpence. Didn't know what he needed to do. And then it was just all my way for the next couple of minutes. But in the second half, I really started to dominate, and this is a corner. It's a lovely ball in, falls back down here, and the only man I want to give this to is Fellaini to spread it out wide. Schaefer, Mr. Packet Schaefer galore. Beautiful turn, beautiful shot, but it's not going to happen today. Schaefer's not going to be on the squad for much longer if he keeps shooting like that. Ben Arfa gets a rare start today. Did he start? I'm not too sure, but it's beautiful footwork, whatever. And I'm just applying so much pressure, and eventually it falls, and it's in the back of the net. I'm not even going to celebrate that because it's a beautiful goal. I think it's Kaleja. I'm nearly sure it's Kaleja. There's the manager just showing his softer side. He has dyed his hair back. And this is Gigi Buffon. Now watch where I'm positioned with this. Absolutely ridiculous. I don't know what happened. The HDPVR probably cut out there. But he did slot it in over my head. And Gigi Buffon had a howler. So in the 75th minute, disaster strikes. And it's just scripting at its finest. Beautiful finish from Pato, who's, I'd love to buy in it maybe in the future. And then the 80th minute, a couple of minutes later, I'm defending valiantly here, lose the ball, and it's just 1-2 direct, and Pato just finishes. Unbelievably, I'm going to lose this match after being 2-0 up. So never say never in Pez, and Bayern Munich just show me that little bit of class is all it needs. So we're straight into fixture 3 in the Champions League. I won fixture 2 in the group stage with a 1-0 victory over, I don't know who it was. It was a penalty anyway, it was a boring game. Belhanda sets up Rivieri, and that's beautiful teamwork there from the two boys. And these came back strong. I thought it was a struggling match now. The prestige was really on his ball, on his game today. That's a good header though. They ripped us apart there. And Cruel back in goal. But they went actually 2-1 up. Then Natalie slotted it home there. but I rescued it with Farnos, dropping it into Colley's head. What a diving header. Beautiful finish, right over the goalkeeper's left arm. And then I stole it in the 85th minute. Rivieri, that man again. He gets a knock on to Colley, back to Colley, and then Colley just puts it back into the back of the net. Unbelievable volley, or a lob, I should say. So I'm in Group E. I've 10 goals, 7 points after 3 games. But that's just about it, lads. Quick upload today, and I'm trying to get Season 5 done as quick as I can, because I'm into Season 6 as it is, and it's been brilliant. So I want to get it up to you as soon as I can.